हेलो एवरीवन, स्वागत है आप सभी का। सो वेलकम टू टेक्यूब गेट क्लासेस एंड इनिशिएटिव बाय टेक्यूब फैकल्टी। सो दिस इज द लेक्चर नंबर 2 ऑफ आवर ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन सीरीज। इससे पहले कि लेक्चर में हमने देख चुके थे कि व्हाट इज द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड द मोटिवेशन ऑफ अ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। हम ये भी देख चुके थे कि हाउ टू फाइंड द ऑर्डर एंड डिग्री ऑफ अ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड हाउ टू चेक वेदर इक्वेशन इज लीनियर एंड नॉन लीनियर। Now in this lecture, we will start from the formulation of a differential equation and then we will see the types of solution of a differential equation and then we will see the types of problem of a differential equation. तो सबसे पहले हम देखते हैं कि formulation of a differential equation by elimination of arbitrary constant. But before going to start the elimination of arbitrary constant, हमें ये समझना होगा कि differential equation का goal क्या क्या होता है। So if I divide broadly, we can divide the goal of a ordinary differential equation or the goal of a differential equation in 3 category. हम mainly क्या करते हैं? We can formulate our differential equation, we can find the solution of a differential equation and we can study the solution of a differential equation. These are the 3 main goal of a ordinary differential equation or differential equation. From the gate point of view, this formation of a differential equation and the solution of a differential equation are very important. But from the gate point of view, we are not interested too much to find the behavior of the solution of a differential equation, right? So we are worried about throughout this lecture series, the formation and the solution of a ordinary differential equation. Okay, so let us start. The first thing is the formation of ordinary differential equation by elimination of a arbitrary constant. Okay, so when you try to form a differential equation by arbitrary constant, definitely there will be some function will be given and we will try to eliminate the arbitrary constant to form a differential equation. So the basic part of this formation of ordinary differential equation, we want to eliminate the arbitrary constant by elimination of arbitrary constant and by elimination of arbitrary constant of the solution of a differential equation. So a differential equation can be formed, a differential equation can be formed by the elimination of or by the eliminating of by the eliminating of the arbitrary constant of the solution, arbitrary constant of the solution or in the solution. So जो भी function दिया रहेगा, that is some solution of a differential equation, and in that solution we want to eliminate our arbitrary constant to find the differential equation. Okay, one more thing, in when you try to form the differential equation, the basic thing is that whatever the number of arbitrary constant will be involved in the solution, the formulated ordinary differential equation will have the same number of, will have contain the same order of differential equation. Suppose if in the solution, if it contains n number of arbitrary constant, in that case, if you formulate the differential equation, we will get a differential equation of order n. So the order of the formed differential equation will be equal to the number of arbitrary constant. Okay, suppose we are assuming a solution which contains n number of arbitrary constant. So let we are assuming that f इज ए फैमिली ऑफ ए कार विच कंटेन्स एक्स वाई सी वन सी टू एंड अप टू सी एन. हेयर दिस इज द फैमिली ऑफ ए कार. इट विल कंटेन्स इन नंबर ऑफ आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट. सो वेन यू ट्राई टू फॉर्मुलेट द ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन वी विल डिफरेंशिएट अप टू nth ऑर्डर. सो वंस यू डिफरेंशिएट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स, सो डिफरेंशिएट दिस इक्वेशन वन, सपोज दिस इज द इक्वेशन नंबर वन, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स एन टाइम्स. इन दैट केस वी विल गेट, सपोज इफ यू डिफरेंशिएट फर्स्ट टाइम वी आर गेटिंग इन दैट केस 5 1, एंड इन दैट केस दिस फंक्शन विल कंटेन एक्स वाई वाई डस सी वन सी टू एंड सी एन. इफ यू डिफरेंशिएट द सेकेंड टाइम इन दैट केस अगेन वी विल गेट सम फंक्शन दैट इज 5 2 एक्स वाई. इन दैट केस इट विल कंटेन वाई डस वाई डबल डस सी वन सी टू एंड अप टू सी एन. जब हम सेकेंड ऑर्डर का डिफरेंशिएशन करेंगे उन दैट केस एक्स वाई वाई डैश एंड वाई डबल डैश का टर्म रहेगा, साथ साथ सी वन सी टू जो हमारा आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट है वो भी इन्वॉल्व रहेगा. सो वी कैन डू अप टू nth ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव. सो इन दैट केस वी विल गेट अनदर फंक्शन, वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट फंक्शन इज 5n, एंड इन दैट केस इट विल कंटेन एक्स वाई वाई डैश एंड अप टू वाई एन टर्म दैट इज द nth डेरिवेटिव कम, एंड ऑल्सो इट विल कंटेन सी वन सी टू सी थ्री एंड अप टू सी एन equal to 0. So we rename the equation. Suppose when we have differentiate first term, this is suppose the equation number 2, this is the equation number 3, and since we differentiate up to this, so this is our equation number n plus 1. Now we can form the differential equation by eliminating this arbitrary constant c1 c2 c3 up to cn from this n plus 1 equation, and we will get a ordinary differential equation which will contain the nth order derivative. So in that case the order of a differential equation, the form differential equation will be n. This is the general thing that I have taken where we are assuming that there are n number of constant. Yahan par humne assume kiya hai ki yahan par kitne number of constant arbitrary constant, n number. We can go up to nth order derivative. We cannot go beyond nth order derivative. Right, so in that n plus 1 equation we can eliminate our c1 c2 c3 up to cn and we will get a ordinary differential equation of order n. So the next thing will be the eliminating this n unknowns, that is c1 c2 c3 and up to cn, using the above n plus 1 equations, and we will get our required, we will get the required differential equation, and that differential equation must have contain the nth derivative, and in that case the order of the form differential equation will be n. ओके, मान लेते हैं कि हमारा डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन में एक ही आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट इन्वॉल्व है, दैट इज सी वन, एक ही. सो इन दैट केस इफ यू ट्राई टू फॉर्म द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन यू विल गेट अ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. अगर हमारा डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन में दो आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट है, इन दैट केस व्हेन यू ट्राई टू फॉर्म द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, इन दैट केस द ऑर्डर ऑफ अ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन बी टू. हम उससे ज़्यादा डेरिवेटिव नहीं कर सकते. ओके, नाउ आई एम टेकिंग सम एग्जाम्पल and I'll show you how you can formulate the differential equation by elimination of a arbitrary constant. Okay, so let us take our first example, y is equal to mx. Ye ek equation hai, y is equal to mx. This is the equation that is the family of a straight line which is passing through origin. Ye ek tarah ki equation hai which is passing through origin. That is the family of, this is our family of a straight line which is passing through 0 0, that is origin, which is passing through origin, and here m is arbitrary constant. तो यहाँ पे कितने नंबर ऑफ आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट, हेयर देयर इज ओनली वन आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट। सो व्हेन यू ट्राई टू फॉर्म द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन वी कैन गो अप टू फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव। सो वंस यू डिफरेंशिएट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स वी विल गेट वाई डैश, और वी कैन ऑल्सो राइट डी वाई बाई डी एक्स विच विल बी एम। राइट, नाउ फ्रॉम दिस टू एक्सप्रेशन दैट इज वाई इक्वल टू एम एक्स एंड वाई डैश इक्वल टू एम, वी कैन एलिमिनेट आवर एम एंड वी कैन फाइंड द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन वेयर there will be no arbitrary constant. So once you eliminate, we can replace the value of m is our y dash, or we can calculate the value of m from our first expression, that is m will be it's a y by x. So y dash equal to it's a y by x, and we can write it's x y dash equal to y. So this is our required differential equation, and the order of a differential equation is 1. अब आप पूछ सकते हो कि सर क्या हम सेकेंड ऑर्डर तक भी तो जा सकते हैं, सो दैट वी कैन एलिमिनेट दिस एम? यस वी कैन, बट इन दैट केस सपोज इफ यू आर टेकिंग द सेकेंड डेरिवेटिव, इन दैट केस यू विल गेट 0. दिस इज ऑल्सो डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, बट दिस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन हैज डिफरेंट सोल्यूशन which is not the solution of this one, that is y equal to mx. If you try to simplify this differential equation, you will get a solution like y equal to c1x plus c2. Because this differential equation is a second order differential equation, and when you try to solve, you will get the two number of arbitrary constant. So, ye mil raha hai, but this is not the general solution of that one. So remember this thing, whatever the number of arbitrary constant will be involved, we can go up to that one. We cannot go beyond the number of arbitrary constant derivative. Okay, so we cannot write this one, right, for this y equal to mx. Okay, again I am taking another example. Okay, y is equal to suppose c into x minus c whole square. In that case, c is our arbitrary constant. Right? Here, there is only one arbitrary constant, so we can go up to the first order derivative. So once you differentiate, we will get dy by dx, and we can write it's a 2c x minus c. Right? Now we want to eliminate this arbitrary constant c from these two expressions. Remember that here only one arbitrary constant is there, that is c. So hum yahan pe 1th order tak hi jayenge, usse zyada hum nahi ja sakte. If you go, you can write, but in that case y equal to c into x minus c square, whatever the function is given, that will be the not the solution of that differential equation. That will be the not general solution of that differential equation. Okay, now from this expression we can eliminate our c. So c kaise hum nikal sakte hain? We can find the value of c from any one of expression, and we can replace in other one, so that we will get our differential equation or the required differential equation. Okay, so from here you can see that suppose this is the expression number 1, that is our given solution, and this is our equation number 2. We want to eliminate c to form a differential equation. So what I am going to do, just I am going to divide these two expressions so that we can eliminate this the outer term c, and we can find the value of c from this x minus c term. Suppose I am applying 2 divided by 1. So in that case we can write y dash, that is our dy by dx divided by y. So we are just dividing 2 by 1, and hum yahan par division kar rahe hain 2 by 1. So 2 by 1, that is our dy by dx divided by y, and which will be our, it's a 2c into x minus c divided by c into x minus c squares. In that case cc will cancel, so we are getting 2 by x minus c. Okay, from here we can calculate now the value of a c, so that we can eliminate our arbitrary constant c from this equation number 1 and equation number 2. So yahan pe c ka value kya hoga hamara? So the value of c will be, we can write this as x minus c इक्वल टू 2y by y dash, and then we can find the value for c. So in that case, we will get the value for c will be, it's a minus 2y by y dash and plus x. This is the value of c we can get from this expression. Now we can replace this c in any one of the expression so that we will get our required differential equation. So suppose I am taking the equation number 1, so y equal to, now the value of c is our minus 2y divided by y dash plus x, and x minus c value will be our, see, x minus c value will be our 2y into y dash. So this is our required differential equation. और इसका order कितना होगा? इसका order हमारा है first order differential equation. We can further simplify and we can write also, but anyway, whatever you want to do, you can do the simplification, you will get a first order differential equation. So this thing we can write as a y into y dash equal to minus 2y plus x y dash into 2y, right? So this is the, or you can cancel y here, so we will get y dash equal to minus 2y. Okay, one y dash will be here, so we can write y dash whole square, because 2y divided by y dash, and here is y dash, so y dash whole square. Now we can write y dash whole square equal to minus 2y plus x y dash into 2. So this is the required differential equation which has order 1. Okay, again I am taking another example. Suppose this is the example number 3. So y is equal to, suppose, a cos x and b sin x is given. Y equal to a cos x plus b sin x, where a and b are the arbitrary constant. यहाँ पर हमारा a और b क्या है? Arbitrary constant है. तो यहाँ पर जो हमारा differential equation बनेगा वो second order का differential equation बनेगा. So we can go the derivative up to second order. So once you differentiate the first terms, we will get y dash, and we can write a, the derivative of cos x will be minus sin x, so a minus sin x plus the derivative of sin x will be cos x, so b cos x. We can do one more derivative, because here the arbitrary constant, the number of arbitrary constant is 2. So once you differentiate second time, we can write minus, again we are differentiating with respect to x, so minus a square and cos x, and the derivative of cos x will be minus sin x, so it will be, sorry, this is only a, it's a minus b and sin x. Now if you check, we want to eliminate a and b from these three expression, y, y dash and y double dash. So if you notice, this y dash is nothing but, we can write it's a minus times of, if you take the common minus, we can write a cos x plus b sin x. Or jo hamara a cos x b sin x hai, wahi hamara y hai. So we can write this one as a minus y dash. So y double dash equal to minus y dash, which is our y dash, sorry, y double dash plus y equal to 0. So ye hamara differential equation bana. And is differential equation ka order kitna hai? This differential equation has order 2, because here the number of arbitrary constant is 2. So yaad rakhe ki jitna bhi arbitrary constant involved hoga in a solution, when you try to find the differential equation, the order of a differential equation will exactly equal to the number of arbitrary constant which will be involved in the solution of any differential equation. Okay, again I am taking another example. Suppose y is equal to, it is given, suppose c1 e to the power of 2x and plus c2 e to the power of minus 2x. मैं एक अलग से example ले रहा हूँ. So again in that case, c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant. So here the number of arbitrary constant आर टू, सो वी कैन गो अप टू द सेकेंड ऑर्डर डेरिवेटिव. सो अगर हम फर्स्ट टाइम करेंगे तो क्या आएगा, वाई डैश इक्वल टू टू टाइम्स ऑफ सी वन, हम यहाँ पर डिफ्रेंशिएट कर रहे हैं विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स, टू टाइम्स ऑफ सी वन ई टू द पावर ऑफ टू एक्स माइनस टू टाइम्स ऑफ सॉरी माइनस टू टाइम्स ऑफ सी टू ई टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस टू एक्स. एंड अगेन वी कैन डू द डिफ्रेंशिएशन वाई डबल डैश इक्वल टू इट्स 2 into 2, that is 4c1 e to the power of 2x, and now we can write it's a minus 2 and minus 2, that will be plus 4c2 e to the power of minus 2x. And now if you notice this thing 4c1 e to the power of 2x, we can write 4c1 e to the power of 2x plus 4c2 e to the power of minus 2x, we can write this thing as a 4 times of y. So what will be our differential equation? Y double dash equal to 4y. So ye hamara bana differential equation, and this differential equation has order 2 because here the number of arbitrary constant is 2, one is c1 and one is c2. Right? Now based on this result, that is the based on the example number 4, that is when y equal to some exponential term like 2 exponential term e to the power of something t to 2x and e to the power of here it is minus 2x, agar e to the power of x mein diya rahega, so we can directly write our form differential equation. So I'm going to write the trick or as a result. So this is one result, the result number 1. So suppose when sometimes when the differential equation will be form of some y equal to like c1 e to the power of ax plus c2 e to the power of bx, हमने मान लिया इस तरह का differential equation का solution दिया हुआ है where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant, c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant and these a and b are normal constant. So यहाँ पर दो ही arbitrary constant, कौन सा, C1 and C2. So इस केस में डायरेक्ट हम लिख सकते हैं इसका रिजल्ट. यू कैन ऑल्सो डिफ्रेंशिएट टू टाइम एंड यू कैन फॉर्मुलेट द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, बट एनी वे इफ द सॉल्यूशन फॉर्म इज लाइक इन एक्सपोनेंशियल फॉर्म, देन वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट द फॉर्म डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. सो द फॉर्म डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन कैसा होगा, द फॉर्म डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विल बी इट्स अ वाई डबल डैश, क्यों, क्योंकि यहाँ पर हमारा नंबर ऑफ आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट टू है. सो वाई डबल डैश माइनस ए प्लस बी वाई डैश एंड प्लस ए बी वाई इक्वल टू जीरो. यू कैन ऑल्सो डिफ्रेंशिएट टू टाइम एंड यू कैन फॉर्म, यू विल गेट दिस वन. सो यू कैन यूज दिस फॉर्म डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ this kind of a solution, that is c1 e to the power of x plus c2 e to the power of bx. For example, suppose करें कि मैं मैंने लिया कि एक differential equation का solution का जो form है c1 e to the power of 2x plus c2 e to the power of 3x. So you can differentiate two time and you can form the differential equation. Or you can use this result directly and you can write your formed differential equation. So what will be the differential equation for this case? The differential equation will be, it's a y double dash minus, it's a plus b, here a is 2 and b is 3, so 2 plus 3, that is 5, so 5 y dash plus ab, that is 2 into 3, that is 6 y equal to 0. So this is our formed differential equation. So if two arbitrary constant is given and that arbitrary constant the solution is written in the form of exponential term, that is 2 exponential term, then we can use this result directly and we can find the form differential equation. So this is one kind of a result. Okay, again till now we have covered the fourth example. Now I'm going to take another example, that is the example number 5. So suppose the solution of a differential equation is given, it's a y equal to ax plus bx square, where a and b are arbitrary constant. A and b are arbitrary constant. Right? So now we can form the differential equation by differentiating 2 times of this solution. So अगर हम पहली बार करेंगे तो क्या होगा, y dash equal to it's a and plus 2bx. And we can go up to the second order. Why? Because here the number of arbitrary constant is 2. So y double dash will be it's a 2b. Okay, now we can eliminate a and b from this 3 expression. From this 3 expression we can eliminate a and b and we can form our differential equation. So यहाँ से हम देख सकते हैं कि b the third expression से हम यहाँ से b का value मिल जाएगा, that is b equal to y double dash by 2. Okay, if you know the value of b, then we can find the value of a from the second expression, that is from here. So we can write a equal to as our y dash minus 2bx. So 2 and b is our y double dash by 2. So y double dash by 2 into x. So which is our y dash minus 2y double dash x. This is the value of a. Now we get the value of a and b. हमें मिल चुका है. We can replace and we can write our formed differential equation. So from 1 we can write y is equal to, here a is our, it's a y dash minus 2y double dash x into x plus b. क्या मिला हमें? B हमें मिला y double dash by 2 into x square. Right? So this is our formed differential equation and you can simplify also and you can write in a simple form also. Right? So suppose I'm going to simplify this one. So what we can write now, 2y equal to, it's a 2y dash minus 2y double dash x square and then x square y double dash. So इसे हम कैसे लिख सकते हैं? Now first we can write the second derivative term and then we can write the first derivative term and then we can write the only our dependent term, that is y term. So y double dash का क्या होगा coefficient, that is x square y double dash, sorry minus 2y double dash into x square and this is x square y double dash. So we can simplify and we are getting minus x square y double dash. And if you bring in the left hand side, that is x square y double dash हमें मिला. Y dash का coefficient क्या आएगा? Y dash is simply 2y dash, that will be our minus 2y dash. And this minus 2y will be simply it's a this one. So this is the formed differential equation, that is x square y double dash minus here one term, that is y dash into x, that will be 2x here. So 2x here. So x square y double dash minus 2x y dash plus 2y equal to 0. This is our formed differential equation. This is our formed differential equation. यहाँ पर order of differential equation कितना है? The order of a differential equation is 2. Okay, now I am going to write another result. Sometimes if some solution is given a times of some algebraic function plus b times of some algebraic function or some exponential term also, then you can use, then we can write directly the form differential equation. So I am going to write that result also. You can also differentiate and you can form the differential equation, but here I am going to write a result so that you can, within a very less time, you can directly write your form differential equation. So this is the result number 2. Okay, suppose if y is equal to the given, that is a times of f of x plus b times of g of x. Here a and b are arbitrary constant. यहाँ पे कितने arbitrary constant है? 2 है, a and b. Now this fx and gx will be some function of either, it will be some algebraic function or it can be some exponential function. So here we assume that here fx and gx are algebraic or exponential. Exponentials. Then in that case, the required डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विल बी वी कैन राइट इन डिटर्मिनेंट फॉर्म. सो वी कैन राइट y f g देन y डैश f डैश g डैश y डबल डैश f डबल डैश एंड g डबल डैश. सो व्हाट इज f एंड g? f एंड g क्या है? f एंड b g जो है हमारा, जो हमने लिखा है सॉल्यूशन दिस वन, a टाइम्स ऑफ f एंड b टाइम्स ऑफ g. सो वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट दिस डिटर्मिनेंट इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड वी विल गेट आवर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर्म्ड डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. रिमेंबर दैट हेयर दिस रिजल्ट इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर अल्जेब्रिक और एक्सपोनेंशियल. सो आइदर दोनों एक्सपोनेंशियल हो सकता है, दोनों अल्जेब्रिक हो सकता है, और एक एक्सपोनेंशियल और एक अल्जेब्रिक हो सकता है. इन दैट केस वी कैन राइट आवर डायरेक्ट डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन इन ए डिटर्मिनेंट फॉर्म. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फॉर सपोज फॉर द लास्ट एग्जाम्पल हमने लिया था वाई इक्वल टू ए एक्स प्लस बी एक्स स्क्वायर, राइट? दिस इज आवर पॉलिनोमियल फंक्शन एक्स एंड एक्स स्क्वायर. सो वी नो दैट पॉलिनोमियल फंक्शन इज ए सबसेट ऑफ आवर अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन, अल्जेब्रिक फंक्शन. ओके, सो वी कैन राइट आवर डायरेक्ट रिजल्ट, दैट डायरेक्ट वी कैन यूज दिस डायरेक्ट रिजल्ट टू फॉर्म आवर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. सो वॉट इज आवर एफ? द फर्स्ट फंक्शन दिस वन इज आवर एफ एंड दिस फंक्शन इज आवर जी. So what will be the required differential equation? The required differential equation we can write in a determinant form. So okay, first check what is y and y dash and y double dash. This will be same because here since the number of arbitrary constant is 2, that is a and b. So we can go up to the second order. So y, y dash and y double dash. Okay, pehla function kya hai hamara x, which is our f. So f first time once you differentiate that is f dash 1 and second times once you differentiate that is 0. g kya hai hamara? g hamara x square hai. So we can write g x square, then the derivative 2x and after the second derivative that is 0. Okay, now you can simplify this determinant. You can simplify this. Okay, this one will be 2, not because second time derivative, the differentiation of a 2x will be, it's a 2. Okay, now we can expand this determinant and we can find the form differential equation. So हम कहीं से भी इसको expand कर सकते हैं along any row or any column. So if you use the first column, then you will get directly result, or you will get the directly coefficient of y, y dash and y double dash. So suppose I am expanding along the first column. So if you expand along the first column, that is y. Yeah, the first entry is y, and if we are expanding along the first column, so 1 into 2 and 0 into 2x, that is simply 2. Okay, minus y dash, in that case 2x minus 0, so that will be simply 2x. And then y double dash, so y double dash will be itself simply 2x square minus x square, so this will be x square equal to 0. So see, we are getting x square y double dash minus 2x y dash and 2y equal to 0. This is our formed differential equation, or this is the required differential equation. See this result, हमने जब differentiation करके भी जब किया था, we get the same result, that is the same differential equation. So either you can do like this, or you can directly use this result to form the differential equation. But remember that this result is applicable when fx and gx are either algebraic or exponential. In that case, we can write our formed differential equation. So you can use this result as a result when fx and gx will be either algebraic or exponential or both. Okay, now I'm going to discuss the solution of ordinary differential equation. But before going to start the solution of ordinary differential equation, first we'll try to understand some general form of a nth order differential equation. So let f as a function of x, y, y dash, y double dash and up to yn. So here the highest order derivative is our nth order. So this is our nth order differential equation. दिस इज द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ए nth ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. दिस इक्वेशन मे बी लीनियर, मे नॉट, मे बी नॉन लीनियर. सो सपोज इफ यू टेक द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन इन ए जनरल फॉर्म, सो इन दैट केस वी कैन राइट एज ए एफ एज ए फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स वाई एंड वाई डैश. इन दैट केस दिस इज विल द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ए फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. इफ यू टेक द सेकेंड ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, इन दैट केस वी कैन राइट एफ एज ए फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स वाई वाई डैश एंड वाई. दिस इज सम वे टू राइट द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ए एनी nth ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. सो दिस इज आवर nth ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, दिस वन. दिस मे बी लीनियर, दिस मे बी नॉन लीनियर ऑल्सो. सो इट विल बी लीनियर वेन इट विल बी लीनियर इफ एफ इज ए लीनियर फंक्शन. दैट इज वेन एफ विल बी लीनियर फंक्शन वेन द डिग्री ऑफ और वेन दिस इज द अननोन फंक्शन विल बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ लीनियर एंड ऑल्सो द डेरिवेटिव टर्म विल ऑल्सो बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ ए लीनियर टर्म एंड दे आर नॉट ऑकर टूगेदर. दैट इज द कंडीशन ऑफ ए लीनियरिटी. दैट लीनियरिटी थिंग वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन आवर लेक्चर नंबर वन. सो दैट मीन्स इफ एफ विल फॉलो द लीनियर फंक्शन इन दैट केस दैट विल बी आवर लीनियर इन nth ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. एंड रिमेंबर दैट हेयर द वेरिएबल इज आवर वाई वाई डैश वाई डबल डैश एंड अप टू वाई एन. सो दैट मीन्स दिस फंक्शन एफ विल बी लीनियर इन द वेरिएबल वाई, दैट इज द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव. देन इन दैट केस दैट जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ nth ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विल बी आवर लीनियर nth ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. Where what is the meaning of yi? Here yi means it's a ith order derivative. So if you take I equal to 1, in that case the first order derivative. If you take I equal to 2, that will be our second order derivative. So this f will be linear when this function f is a linear function in the variable of y, y dash, y double dash and up to yn. That is, this should be linear in the dependent variable and its derivative. So this is the general form of any nth order linear, sorry, this is the general form of any nth order ordinary differential equation. That is f of x, y, y dash, y double dash and up to yn. Aur isko linear kab bolenge? When this function f is a linear function in our dependent variable and it's all derivative. And they are not occurred together also. Okay, now I am going to discuss this nth order linear differential equation. So we can write this nth order linear differential equation in some explicit form. So consider this one, an x yn. This yn meaning is that nth order derivative, an minus n yn minus 1 and up to a1x y dash plus a0x y equal to gx. So this is our nth order differential equation. This is linear nth order differential equation because it follows all the condition of a linearity. That is, it is a linear in terms of dependent variable and its derivative and they are not multiple together. So that's why this is our nth order linear differential equation. Okay, what is here an, an minus 1, an minus 2 up to a naught? These are the some constant, these are the some function of x or it can be some constant. So when this an, an minus 1, an minus 2, if it is some function of x, then in that case this we call as a nth order differential equation with variable coefficient. And when an, an minus 1, if all are some constant, in that case we can say that that is our nth order differential equation with constant coefficient. That is the nth order linear differential equation with constant coefficient. So this is the general form of a linear nth order differential equation. This sometimes it will be variable coefficient, sometimes it will be a constant coefficient. So variable coefficient or constant coefficient kab samjhenge? Hum dekhenge derivative ka coefficient. If all the derivative coefficient, if it is a constant, then in that case that will be a problem of a, that will be a equation of a linear differential equation with constant coefficient. And at least one of the coefficient of the derivative, it is, if it is some function of x, that is function of independent variable, then in that case that will be a type of a linear nth order ordinary differential equation with variable coefficient. And when you say that this is the nth order differential equation, remember that the coefficient of the highest order derivative should not equal to 0. If it is 0, then we cannot say that this is our nth order differential equation. So that's why this coefficient should not equal to 0. Okay, another thing, see the right hand side, this is a function of g as a function of x. If this function g of x, if it is 0, then it is called the linear nth order homogeneous differential equation. If the right hand side, if it is 0, and in this case we can say that the linear nth order homogeneous differential equation. And if the right hand side is not equal to 0, then in this case we can say that is the linear nth order non-homogeneous differential equation. Okay, so now we are going to discuss the types of solution. अब हम देखेंगे कितने तरह के सॉल्यूशन होते हैं डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन में. सो फर्स्ट विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सॉल्यूशन. हम सॉल्यूशन क्या बोल सकते हैं? ए सॉल्यूशन इज नथिंग बट इट्स अ रिलेशन बिटवीन द वेरिएबल विच विल सेटिस्फाई एनी इक्वेशन. सो सिंस यहाँ पर हम सॉल्यूशन की जो बात कर रहे हैं वो ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन का सॉल्यूशन है. सो दैट मीन्स देयर इज सम रिलेशन बिटवीन द वेरिएबल दैट इज एक्स एंड वाई विच विल सेटिस्फाई द इक्वेशन, the given ordinary differential equation, that is called the solution. For example, suppose I am taking y double dash plus y equal to 0. This is some differential equation. This is our second order differential equation. And in this case, suppose I am taking y is equal to this sin x is the solution. So how we can say that this is a solution? If you satisfy this y, that is the relation between this variable y and x, if you replace this value in our equation, this solution will satisfy this equation. So that's why we can say that y equal to sin x is the solution of the differential equation. Here I am saying that this solution we cannot say that this is a general solution, particular solution or singular solution. So later we will come the general solution, singular solution and the particular solution. So right now this is some solution. Why? This relation, that is y equal to sin x, which will satisfy this equation. So that is simply a solution. Okay, now we are going to discuss the types of solution of a differential equation. So there are three type of a solution. We can classify this ordinary differential equation in a three type of solution. One is the general solution, one is the particular solution and one is the singular solution. हम किसी भी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन को सॉल्यूशन को हम क्लासिफाई कर सकते हैं इन थ्री कैटेगरी में. क्या है? जनरल सॉल्यूशन, पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन एंड द सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन. सो नाउ वी विल सी वन बाय वन व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ जनरल सॉल्यूशन, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन एंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन. सो जनरल सॉल्यूशन कब बोलेंगे? किसी इक्वेशन का, किसी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन का सॉल्यूशन जनरल सॉल्यूशन कब बोल सकते हैं? सो द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ ए डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, if it is involving as many of independent arbitrary constant which is equal to the order of a differential equation, in that case that solution will be general solution. यानी कोई भी solution जिसमें जो number of independent arbitrary constant है वो अगर order of differential equation के बराबर होगी, in that case that solution will call as a general solution. This is sometimes also called the complete solution or the complete integral. Okay, so the general solution, the solution of a differential equation which is involving as many independent arbitrary constant as the order of a differential equation, is called the general solution. The general solution or the complete solution, this is also called the complete solution कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन और कंप्लीट इंटीग्रल. All these terms are same, general solution, complete solution or the complete integral. And sometimes it is also called the complete primitive. Complete primitive. So these all terms, the meaning is that this is the general solution. So in a simple word, we can see that whatever the order of a differential equation, if in the solution, if it contains the same number of independent arbitrary constant, in that case, that solution will be our general solution. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मान लेते हैं कि हमारा एक डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन सेकेंड ऑर्डर का है और उसके सॉल्यूशन में दो आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट इन्वॉल्व है. सो इन दैट केस दैट सॉल्यूशन विल बी आवर जनरल सॉल्यूशन और द कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सपोज y डबल डैश प्लस y इक्वल टू जीरो एंड सपोज द सॉल्यूशन इज गिवन y इक्वल टू सी वन कॉस एक्स प्लस सी टू साइन एक्स. सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस टू आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट आर इंडिपेंडेंट एंड here there is two arbitrary constant c1 and c2 and the order of a differential equation is 2. So we can say that this solution is our, it's a general solution of a differential equation. Okay, next we are going to discuss the particular solution. Okay, so the particular solution is basically which is obtaining from general solution by assigning some particular value in the general solution that solution will call as a particular solution. So a solution obtained by assigning particular value of the arbitrary constant in the general solution. Any general solution jo arbitrary constant hai, if you assign some particular value, in that case that solution will be our, it's a particular solution. So by assigning some particular value of the arbitrary constant in the general solution is called particular solution. So basically we can derive the particular solution from our general solution, we call as a particular solution. So whatever the general solution is given, if you are assigning some particular value, that is the arbitrary constant, in the general solution, that solution will be our particular solution. Okay, next we are going to discuss the singular solution. So a singular solution of a differential equation, the main identification is that which doesn't contain any arbitrary constant and it can nor be obtained from general solution, that solution will be our singular solution. So a solution of a differential equation, which doesn't, contain any arbitrary constant, also nor can be derived from the general solution. A solution which is not containing any arbitrary constant, also nor can be derived from the general solution by assigning any particular value, by assigning any particular value that solution will known as दैट सॉल्यूशन टू बी नॉन एज एज आर्बिट एज ए सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट इट्स कॉल्ड सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन. सो सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन में क्या होगा, सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन द फर्स्ट आइडेंटिफिकेशन इज दैट इट विल नॉट कंटेन एनी आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट. ऑल्सो इट कैन नॉट बी डिराइव फ्रॉम द जनरल सॉल्यूशन बाई असाइनिंग एनी पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू टू द आर्बिट्री कॉन्स्टेंट दैट इज कॉल्ड आवर सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन. सो दीज आर द थ्री टाइप ऑफ ए सॉल्यूशन ऑफ ए डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, वन इज द जनरल, वन इज द पर्टिकुलर एंड वन इज द सिंगुलर. सो जनरल सॉल्यूशन क्या होगा, जिसमें जो हमारी आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट होगी वो ऑर्डर ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन के बराबर होगी, इन दैट केस दैट सॉल्यूशन विल बी आवर जनरल सॉल्यूशन और कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन. इन द केस ऑफ ए पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन वी कैन डिराइव द पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन बाय असाइनिंग सम पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू इन द आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट इन द जनरल सॉल्यूशन दैट सॉल्यूशन विल बी आवर पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन. एंड सिंगुलर सॉल्यूशन में क्या होगा, इट विल नॉट कंटेन एनी आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट एंड इट कैन नॉट बी डिराइव फ्रॉम द जनरल सॉल्यूशन by assigning any particular value in the arbitrary constant, that type of a solution will be our singular solution of a differential equation. Okay, next we are going to discuss, till now we covered the types of solution. Now we are going to discuss the types of problem of a ordinary differential equation. So the types of a problem of a ordinary differential equation, we can classify the types of problem in two part. One is the initial value problem and one is the boundary value problem. One is the initial value problem and one is the boundary value problem. Okay, so first I am going to discuss what is initial value problem. So the initial value problem and initial value problem of the ordinary differential equation of the ordinary differential equation that is f of x y y dash y double dash and up to y, we are assuming that this is our nth order differential equation. So an initial value problem of an ordinary differential equation that is the nth order differential equation and where x belongs to some interval. So together with this differential equation there will be some supplementary condition. So an differential equation together with some supplementary condition, so together with a set of supplementary condition and that condition is like it's a y x not equal to some value a not, suppose y dash x not equal to a one suppose, and up to, since this is a nth order differential equation, here we are assuming that this is our nth order differential equation. So in that case, whatever the order of a differential equation, we have the same number of supplementary conditions. So in that case there will be n number of supplementary condition. So that is our up to y n minus 1 x naught, and there is some value, we are assuming that that value is our a n minus 1. Remember that in the case of initial value problem, we are taking the value x naught in all the condition. This is the same value, and this x naught value will be belong from our interval, that is the any value from the interval. So the value of unknown is specified at some point and all the derivative value is specified at the same point. So that type of a differential equation with this condition is called the initial value problem. For example, suppose we are taking a first order differential equation. In that case, the function will have contain x, y and y dash. So in case mein kya hoga, since this is for the first order differential equation, we will have only one supplementary condition, that is in that case y x not equal to a naught. Suppose we have taken second order differential equation, in that case x y y dash and y double dash is charo term involved rahenge. In that case we require the two condition in our initial value problem. that is y x naught and y dash x naught. Remember that here x naught is any value of the interval, and that value will be the same in y as well as in y dash and also the higher order derivative. So initial value problem में जो भी हम point लेंगे that is the same point in all the derivative. And what is a naught, a one up to a n? This a naught here, this a naught, a one up to a n minus one. Since here we are assuming that nth order differential equation, so this a naught, a one, these are the n number of constant, and this constant must be a constant coefficient. It's a constant term. So here a naught, a one up to a n minus one, these are some constant, that constant is fixed constant sum, fixed constant. And what is x naught? X naught is any point which lie our interval. So जो भी यहाँ पर differential equation दिया है, whatever the interval is given, in that case that point x naught, that point we consider as our initial point. So x naught belongs to our interval I. For example, suppose I am taking the for the first order differential equation. So in that case, the differential equation form will be general form will be x, y, and y dash equal to 0. So together with that will be some supplementary condition. Suppose y x naught equal to a naught. Because this is a first order differential equation, so in that case there will be only one supplementary condition. That is y at x naught. And what is x naught? X naught belongs to our interval, and that x naught will treat as our initial point. Okay, fourth example, suppose for the second order differential equation. So in that case, x, y, y dash and y double dash equal to 0. This is our second order differential equation, the general form. So in that case, we can write the two supplementary conditions, that is y, x naught, this x naught at some value, and the derivative at the point x naught will have some value. Suppose we are assuming a naught and a naught. These are the some fixed constant value. So this is the some general structure of first order initial value problem and the second order initial value problem. You can also similarly define the third order, fourth order, and so on. Right. So this is the initial value problem of a differential equation. Remember that in the initial value problem, whatever the point is given, that point will be implemented in all the value like y, y dash, and all the derivative. If you take the nth order differential equation, that the value of y, y dash up to yn minus 1 is given at the same point, that type of a condition will be our initial condition. Okay, so next we are going to discuss the boundary value problem. That is the boundary value. In short, we denote as a BVP. Okay, so what is the boundary value problem? This boundary value problem is nothing but it's a two-point boundary value problem. So a boundary value problem, that is BVP, a boundary value problem, suppose for consist of a ordinary differential equation. Again, we are assuming that this is our nth order differential equation. That is f of x, y, y dash, and up to yn. This is our nth order differential equation, and x belongs to some interval I. So in a boundary value problem, together with this differential equation, again there will be some supplementary condition about the values of y, y dash, and up to yn minus 1. If you consider, since here this is our nth order differential equation, so in that case we can go up to yn minus 1. So together with this problem, we have some supplementary condition, that is our set of supplementary condition, about the values of y, that is our dependent variable, y dash, and up to yn minus 1. See here we are assuming that this is our nth order differential equation. So we can assign the supplementary condition on the value of y does up to yn minus 1 at two different points. And remember that two different point, that is two boundary point, that will be our boundary. So whatever the, suppose the interval x is given, that two point will be the boundary of that one. So at two different values, of x in the interval I, and that value will be in our boundary, that will be our two point boundary value problem. So in the interval I, so the boundary condition mainly are prescribed on the boundary, and that boundary here we are assuming that is the two point boundary value problem. So for example, suppose I am taking for second order differential equation, because it is the starting from the second order differential equation. So suppose we have some second order differential equation, for example x f of, as a function of f of x y dash and y double dash. This is our second order differential equation. This may be linear, this may be non-linear also, right? So we can write this, suppose the boundary x interval is from a to b, the interval of x is from a to b. So we can write this equation with some supplementary condition. So when you write ya, suppose one boundary is ya and this value is, suppose we are assuming alpha, and at the other point we are assuming some value is beta. So you can see that here the value of unknown is simply specified at some known point, that is the boundary point a and b, and we are taking only the value of a dependent variable y. But we can also take, since this is a second order derivative, so we can go up to first order derivative. We can write also the condition on a first order derivative. But yahan par hame kitna arbitrary constant hoga, yahan par jab hum solve karenge, we will get the two number of arbitrary constant, and we can find that two value of arbitrary constant from these two conditions. So yahan par humne jo liya hai y at some point and y at other point, that is we are taking the value of y. So this type of a boundary condition is called as a Dirichlet boundary condition. It's a Dirichlet boundary condition. We can also write some value at the derivative. So like y dash at some point a alpha, because we can write on a boundary, on a condition up to the first order derivative. So suppose y dash at a is alpha, and we are assuming that y dash at b is beta. See, we can take any set of the condition. Suppose if we are taking this condition, the value of a dependent variable at a and b. So is tarah condition ko hum kya bolenge, that is a kind of a Dirichlet boundary condition. Agar hum log derivative, dono value derivative le rahe, then in that case that kind of a condition is called the Newman condition. Is our Newman condition, that is the Newman boundary condition. If you suppose if you are taking the boundary condition like weighted combination of Dirichlet and Newman, that kind of a boundary condition we call as a Robin boundary condition. Robin boundary condition. So in that case, what we can write? We in the Robin boundary condition, we are taking the weighted combination of Dirichlet and the Newman boundary condition. So we can write, suppose we are taking the weighted, like suppose C naught and YA, this is our Dirichlet condition, and C1 times of suppose Y dash at A, and the value is alpha. Here we are taking C YA and Y dash. YA is our Dirichlet condition, Y dash is our Newman condition. We are taking the weighted combination of this one, and here we are taking at one point, that is A. We have to take another condition also, like suppose d naught and yb, because we require the two condition to find the arbitrary constant, because this is a two point boundary value problem. So d naught yb plus suppose d1. So what is d naught and d1, and what about c naught and c1? These are the some weight. We are taking some combination form of Dirichlet and Newman condition. So d naught yb and d1 y dash at the other boundary, that is b, and which is our, we assuming that some value is beta. This alpha and beta are the fixed value, are the fixed constant. So this kind of a condition is called, that is, if you take the some weighted combination of a Dirichlet and Neumann condition, that kind of a boundary condition is called the Romin boundary condition. Another boundary condition we can write, this is as a mixed boundary condition. The mixed boundary condition is like that, we can take one value at one boundary point, we can take the Neumann Dirichlet condition, and at other boundary we can take our Neumann condition. So that kind of a condition is called the mixed boundary condition. Suppose we are taking the value y at a is equal to some alpha, and y dash, suppose we are taking the derivative part, y dash b equal to some beta. So this is some combination of our Dirichlet combination, Dirichlet and Neumann boundary condition, but it is separately formed. Or we can also write, suppose the value of y is specified at b, which is our alpha, and the derivative value is our at the point a, that is our, we are assuming some beta. So if we take the combination of a Dirichlet and Neumann separately at the two different boundary a and b, that kind of a boundary condition will be as our mixed boundary condition. So mixed boundary condition mein kya le sakte hain, kisi ek point par hum Neumann condition le sakte hain, kisi ek point par hum Dirichlet condition le sakte hain, that is a type of a mixed boundary condition. And you can also notice that this Romin boundary condition is the generalization of this mixed boundary condition. Suppose if you take C1 equal to 0, that weighted combination, in that case you will get the y a at some alpha. And suppose if you take d not equal to 0, then in that case this value y dash beta equal to y dash b at beta. So this mixed boundary condition is some particular case of a Romin boundary condition. We can derive this, we can write this mixed boundary condition from Romin boundary condition, right? So these are the some conditions of a boundary, like Dirichlet boundary condition, Neumann boundary condition, because here we can replace, here we can assign the value of y and y dash, because here we are taking the second order derivative. And mainly the boundary condition problem, the boundary valuability problem will be starting from our second order derivative, third order derivative, third order differential equation, and so on. Right? Okay, another condition that is called the periodic condition, that is the periodic boundary condition. So particularly if I say, we can divide the whole boundary condition in five category, that is the Dirichlet condition, Neumann condition, Romin condition, mixed boundary condition, and the periodic boundary condition. So the periodic boundary condition, since the boundary is our a and b, so the value of unknown at a equal to the value of unknown at b, and also the derivative value at a and the derivative value at b will be same. So that kind of a condition is called the boundary condition. Yahan pe boundary kya hai hamara, a and b. So humne kya liya, y at a, at x equal to a, and y at x equal to b, these two value will be same, and y dash at x equal to a and y dash at x equal to b, if these two will be same, then that type of a condition is called the periodic boundary condition, right? So we can say that the types of a problem we can classify in two category. One is the initial boundary value problem, one initial value problem, and one is the boundary value problem. And this initial value problem and the boundary value problem may have unique solution, infinite solution, or no solution. So some problem will be given, sometimes the problem will be given initial value problem, sometimes the problem will be given as a boundary value problem. So that initial value problem or the boundary value problem may have unique solution, infinite solution, or no solution. So I'm going to write a remark, please you can note down, this is a very important remark. An initial value problem or boundary value problem of a differential equation may have unique solution, इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन, इन द इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन दैट इज नॉट द यूनिक, समटाइम्स इट विल बी मोर देन वन, दैट इज टू सोल्यूशन, थ्री सोल्यूशन और इनफाइनाइटली नंबर सोल्यूशन. सो वी आर टेकिंग इन कैटेगरी ऑफ इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन. इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन मे बी मोर देन वन सोल्यूशन, दैट इज टू सोल्यूशन, थ्री सोल्यूशन और मोर देन दैट, सो दैट वी कॉल इन ए कैटेगरी ऑफ इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन. सो मे हैव यूनिक सोल्यूशन और इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन और नो सोल्यूशन और नो सोल्यूशन. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इफ सम प्रॉब्लम ऑफ ए डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन गिवन, समटाइम्स सम प्रॉब्लम सम सप्लीमेंट्री कंडीशन विल बी गिवन, sometimes that supplementary condition will be initial condition or some boundary condition. So based on that we can find our arbitrary constant. If you are able to find the arbitrary constant uniquely, in that case that solution will be our unique solution. Suppose that solution is applicable for infinitely many values of arbitrary constant, then in that case that solution will be our infinite solution. And for the no solution, if you replace the condition, whatever the initial condition or the boundary condition, in the solution, in that case if it is not satisfied, then in that case that solution will be our no solution. So this is the way when we try to identify whether the solution is unique, infinite or no solution. Okay, so in this lecture till now what we have covered, we covered the formation of a differential equation. This is the summary of this lecture. We covered the types of solution, that is the general solution, particular solution and singular solution, and we covered the types of problem of differential equation like initial value problem and boundary value problem. So initial value problem or boundary value problem ka role kya hai? जो भी सप्लीमेंट्री कंडीशन दिया गया उस कंडीशन के हेल्प से वी कैन फाइंड आवर आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट. इफ यू आर एबल टू फाइंड द आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट यूनिकली, दैट इज यूनिक वे से हम आर्बिट्री कांस्टेंट निकाल पा रहे हैं, देन दैट केस दैट सोल्यूशन विल बी आवर यूनिक सोल्यूशन. अगर सपोज करो कि फॉर एनी वैल्यूज ऑफ सी दैट सोल्यूशन विल होल्ड, देन इन दैट केस दैट विल बी आवर इनफाइनाइट सोल्यूशन. समटाइम्स किसी पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू वन, किसी पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू लाइक टू थ्री वैल्यू के लिए अप्लीकेबल हो सकता है वो सोल्यूशन, दैट इज द टाइप ऑफ ए टू सोल्यूशन, थ्री सोल्यूशन काइंड ऑफ थिंग. एंड समटाइम्स द वॉट एवर द कंडीशन इज गिवन, इट विल नॉट सेटिस्फाई द सोल्यूशन, दैट इज द टाइप ऑफ ए नो सोल्यूशन. सो वी कवर इन दिस लेक्चर फॉर्मेशन, टाइप्स ऑफ सोल्यूशन एंड टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. ओके, सो in our next lecture we will start from our this solution of a first order and first degree differential equation. So for the timing, thank you for watching the video and thanks for your time. If you have any doubt or any query, please do the comment on our comment section, we will respond very quickly. So keep watching, and again once again thanks for your time. So bye to all and thank you very much.